CryptoSlo, cryptocurrency news and investing.
CryptoSlo with more crypto gains. Tonight's video is a pretty simple but straightforward one. We'll be talking about how do you export all of your private keys from your Raven QT wallet. Now, you know, a lot of people say back up your DAT file, which is a great thing to do. But it's always good to have your private keys. I did find some documentation on Bitcoin Core, but those small little syntactical differences are what make the difference on whether or not this works or not. So let's get started. First thing you need to do is obviously have your Raven wallet running. Then you are going to go to the help screen, debug, and open up the debug window. All right, so now we have the debug window open. There's different tabs. You're going to click on console. And the very first thing you need to do is unlock your wallet. And this is accomplished by putting in your wallet passphrase and the word wallet passphrase. Now, here is the important part. You actually have to put your wallet passphrase in quotes or it will not work. It'll give you, it'll say that it's the wrong wallet password when actually it's probably the right password, right key. That has to be quotes and then your passphrase and then a time, which is in seconds. Now, if you click on the line down here and you start typing, you'll notice wallet, lowercase, gets the autocomplete. See how it says wallet passphrase? Wallet passphrase, space, quotation mark, your passphrase, space, and then a time. So we'll just go 60 seconds. Okay? And I'll actually hit return in this case to show you what it does with the wrong passphrase. Error, wallet passphrase was incorrect. Okay, now I'll go ahead and copy paste the correct one in. And you should receive a null back, and you know that you're correct. So the next step, it's actually the dump wallet command. Okay, space. And quotation marks, this is important. Now, if you try to do C:\ and type keys.txt, quotation marks, it's gonna give you an error, okay? And also, here's another important thing. If you don't specify text file, it's just gonna dump a file with no extension, and then now if you did that by mistake, you can right click on it, open with notepad, and you'll still get the human correlated set of keys. But it's just easier to, you can call this file whatever you want. You can call it my Raven keys, or you may want to name it something ambiguous so that it's more hidden, and then dot text enter. Alright, now I'm going to show you what happens when I try to dump the wallet with the dump wallet. And this, like I said, C:\ my keys dot text and then close the quotation marks. This will actually give you an error. Cannot open wallet dump file. Now, with the Windows machine, that's because you have permissions problems and the application doesn't have admin access or whatever to write to that location. So the easiest way that I found to do this is just to open an Explorer window, okay, and go to your C drive, go to your username, and I'll just pick one of mine, Slowbots, and click up here and copy that. Okay. and then backslash, and we'll call it keys.txt, and enter. That's it. So if you noticed, it dumped all my private keys for my wallet into the keys location. And if you look under Slowbot, you'll see there are all my private keys. Now, with that being said, always use proper security. You're going to want to encrypt that file, put it on a thumb drive, and get it off your computer. Put it in your safe, practice good things and protect those private keys. But now that will actually have all the keys for your entire wallet in that file. So hope you enjoyed tonight's video. Smash that like button, subscribe, and bell notifications for all the latest, greatest crypto tips and investing. This is Crypto Slow. If you're not talking gains, then we're not talking.